afternoon to all of you. I think the afternoon session, I think it looks like that more speakers than the audience that. Okay, it doesn't matter that, you know, the idea has to go down. So it is, I'm Professor Moni, former Director General, National Informatics Center. I thank the organizers for inviting me for this session. And I also welcome the fellow panelists, Mr. Antonio Jara, Mr. Kanchan Devnath, Professor Siva Mangai, and Professor Miko. Mr. Banwarilal Bishna. I think this session is a very important session because anything related to village comes as a last session, you know. And I am working on a system that rather than considering village as a last mile connectivity, but how it can have a first mile connectivity. And even though we have a famous statement from Mahatma Gandhi that the nation's development road goes through the village, you know that, and I do not know when we are going to achieve that. So it's an important thing that sustainable smart village, and in this session I also would like to communicate that under the doubling the farmers' income by 2022, even though the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal has given a target by 2030 that the farmers should get their income doubled. But our Honorable Prime Minister taken a visionary approach that India should achieve 8 years before what the UN SDG goal to be achieved by 2030. So that's why our target is 2022. It has set up an interministerial chairing, committee on doubling the farmers' income by 2022. And if you see the website of the Ministry of Agriculture, lot of draft reports have been uploaded for public view. I'm the group leader for two volumes. One is on agriculture extension, skill development, knowledge diffusion, and ICT. That draft report has been already uploaded, and anybody who would like to look into it, would like to give any suggestions and so on and so forth, you are welcome. Second one is that, digital technology in agriculture. As a science and technology enabler for, the agriculture, and how to have a digital inclusion of about 13 crores farming community. According to the agriculture census, it is about 138 million operational holding. So 90% of the operational holding, it comes into the small and marginal farmers, and this is the size. If it is 85 to 90% of the farming community are small and marginal farmers, and they are the food security net for India, and how this technology, whether it is a space technology or the spatial technology or GIS technology or database technology or internet technology or web technology, how it should go to this 13 crore farming community. And India has about something like 400 agriculture commodities. We have got about 15 agroclimatic, region. It means that throughout the year we can produce, but the thing is you see the situation that 400 agricultural commodities, we don't have even an ICT-enabled agricultural value chain. Canada has got about something like 9 value chain. They grow food only for 6 months or 7 months, but they rule their exports with respect to agricultural commodities. So this is, when you look at it, digital technologies can play an important role. Maybe that today morning I submitted the report to the chairman of the committee, of the Doubling the Farmers Committee on Digital Technology in Agriculture. If anybody is interested, if you wanted to give your views, If you send, you know, your you know your email address to my email address moni@nic.in, I'll be in a position to send the draft copy so that if the report gets, you know, entrenched with your ideas before it gets formally put into the, you know, into the website for public view. And the crux of that is that I was the person who brought the smart village as a plan scheme in 10th plan. It started in 2002. And I wanted to do one village in every state and one in Andaman. This is at that time 28 states. Now is the Telangana 29 and one in Andaman. Because many of the central project, it doesn't go beyond this mainland. So I always put Andaman Nicobar also is one where we should do pilot projects. So, but there was an organizational problems. It didn't come. When our Honorable Prime Minister announced Smart City, and by the time I was the professor, I was working as a professor in the Soviet University, so I sent that proposal to all the people concerned, Smart Village, that. So it is an important thing in this report. Apart from the other things, that if the internet connectivity is there, at least I would have shown the table of the contents. You know, it would have given a lot of interest for the panel members to also talk about it. And, you know, how the formats can be put it. One is that we have to digitally include all the 13 crores formats. Most of them have got smartphones or, digital phones or, the feature phones, how to connect them. And then how to redress their grievances. The government has a public grievances system, but the farmers' grievances system is not operational in the country. And when you look at it, the grievances of with respect to the village of the farmer, you will be in a position to know most of the problems of related to the agricultural scenario of the village. Today, the state government or the district administration, you know, don't have the mechanism to understand the farmers' grievances. That. And then third is that, how to use the social media with respect to as a trusted tool, not to exploit them. One. And then how to bring in 400 agriculture commodity value chain. Anything which the produce which the farmer, you know, produces should find out a market. From farm to the profit market. How to do that? How to have 400 agriculture commodity value chain. And then, I talked about that, this is digitalized access to credit for this, at least the 90% of the farming community, small and marginal farmers. And then, we don't have a good farm health management. You know, even after independence, we're now the 70 years now, you know, you have a plant health system, individual vertical. You have a soil health, is an another vertical. You have an animal health, another vertical. You have another water health, another vertical. And human health. But when it, at the farmer level, he wants an integrated approach like one health, eco-health. So farm health management, if farmer has to reduce his expenditure, unless we adopt a farm health management in an integrated manner, it is a difficult process. To give an indication, and to also quote a Parliament Committee report, by not using the good quality pesticide, not spraying the pesticides in an appropriate time, on 25% of the cultivated area, agriculture, the loss is 90,000 crores per annum. Animal foot and mouth disease alone causing the farmer 20,000 crores loss every year. This is in the two, you know, areas where the loss has to be minimized. Farmer can be, you know, even if he doesn't get the, you know, good, you know, market price, if his, you know, expenditure is reduced like anything, it's nothing like that. So the farm health management is important. I was instrumental for promoting digital networks for farmer through an international conference in May 1995. Informatics for Sustainable Agriculture Development. 15 informatics network have been announced, and some of them have been operationalized. There was the first informatics blueprint for agriculture even before the e-governance program came in 2000. And AgMarketNet is one of the successful programs. We are able to network 3,000 agriculture wholesale mandis out of 7,000 wholesale mandis even by 2007. You know, so what is that? How to bring in these 15 digital networks to the farmer? And then these, you know, this is, you know, farm health management, digitalized access to the, you know, farmers, access to credits, and complete logistics. And then how to achieve digitalized land and water management. Even though you have a Pradhan Mantri Krishi, you know, Sinjai Yojana, but nobody does water budgeting at the grassroots level. Both the surface water and the groundwater. So even in all developed countries, the surface water belongs to government. And in the developed country, even the groundwater belongs to government. But in India, groundwater belongs to the water of the land. And he exploits it. He puts a deep well, like, you know, bore like anything, that he draws the water from even the 2 kilometers, 3 kilometers from the other's land. We don't have a rule to stop this one, that groundwater exploitation. And then the thing is that even though we have a good rainfall, without our permission, the water goes to Bay of Bengal or Arabian Sea. We don't, you know, there is not much water. The Tamil Nadu is the best case. We fight for Kaveri water. When there is water there, it goes to Bay of Bengal without the permission of both the governments. So the thing is that at the grassroots level, sustainable natural resource management is an important thing. Sustainable natural resource management will bring in, you know, sustainable village development and sustainable agriculture development. So if the digital village or digitalized village has to bring in, you know, positive improvement for the farming community, these three projects are more important using all the technologies which we have in command. We have 4,500 engineering colleges who teach computer science. There are more than 18,000 non-engineering colleges who teach computer science. We have 450 agriculture colleges. We have 75 agricultural universities. We have 100 ICR institutions. We have 675 Krishi Vigyan Kendras. We have 650 plus agriculture technology management agency. We have about something like 2,700 regional research stations of various ICR institutions. So if we put together, if each institution can work together and converge at the village level, all schemes, anything which is needed as a village as a unit, if that is taken as a developmental unit, you know, India can achieve. But we have to have a will. It has to have an administrative will. We have to have a management will. And also, above all, there is a social system will. We have a BharatNet, which is supposed to have gone to all the 2.25 lakhs panchayat by 2014. Is yet to go. Madam, the previous session said that previously it was called NYFN. It is said to be still no fun. And so it is all important thing that technology can bring in wonders, and it is possible, and it should be done. And for us, if India has to be is an emerged economy by 2030, the 6.5 lakhs villages have to be smart villages. Everything has to be digitalized into zeros and ones. If it is not possible to be digitized, at least it should be, documents has to be scanned and made it available. Otherwise, even if it is not possible to get it scanned, it has to be through survey methods, we have to get into digitalizations. So it is complex, agriculture is complex, village is complex, but there is a lot of challenges and opportunities. It is not a structured problem, it is an unstructured problem where artificial intelligence and expert systems can play an important role. And a lot of startups can come. Many of the startups which is coming out is not in traditional area. It is an agricultural area. The problem is IT people are coming and getting into agricultural startup, but they don't have an agricultural background. They don't understand agriculture systems. So it is a problem. And agricultural entrepreneurs getting into, you know, startups, that they don't have a background on IT. So that's why, after working in the system, I brought out agricultural informatics as a discipline in the center where I have set, and as a chairman, is the country needs for rural students to get into, because for them, in their DNA, agriculture is there. So to motivate them, to make them as an, it's a good engineer, that we need agriculture and IT as a combined subject to be taught. So that agricultural informatics as a discipline, it is essential. We are also trying to talk about how to bring in block level IT in agriculture, district level IT in agriculture, state level IT in agriculture, and national level IT in agriculture as a discipline to facilitate the 13 crore farmers. That's more important. And with this one, that I invite the panel members to, you know, give their viewpoints, but at least each one should give one action plan. I think we have 6 members, so if we can contribute 6 action points to the organizers, I think our panel, this session, has done its wonders. And I also appreciate and Mr. the success stories from 3 villages. One is from Gramwani, and another that is from IIT Delhi, another is from Bihar, and third is from Gujarat. I think it is some of the things that it is one should understand. People like us who work from the AC environment, but the thing is, we should also see the grassroots level experiences as how it works.